This is a demonstration of the power flow through the Chrysler NAG1, that's NAG1, 5-speed automatic transmission. This transmission is made by Mercedes Benz and is also known as the W5A580 transmission. This transmission has 3 planetary gear sets in it to achieve the 5 forward gears and 1 reverse gear. There's a simple planetary gear set in the front and a Simpson gear set in the rear. A Simpson has a common sun gear. As far as components with this transmission, we have the input shaft from the engine, the torque converter, and the turbine in the engine, which turns our input shaft or turbine shaft. That turbine shaft connects to the annulus gear or ring gear in the front planetary gear set. We have a B1 brake that's down in this housing here. That's also connected to an F1 sprag. If you recall, a sprag only rotates in one direction and locks up in the other direction. So this sprag is going to lock up during acceleration and freewheel during deceleration. The B1 brake and the F1 sprag connect to the front sun gear. We have a K1 clutch that's underneath this housing here that connects these two housings together. The K1 clutch is connected to the front planet carrier and the rear annulus gear. And then down underneath this lower housing here, we have a K2 clutch that's connected to a center annulus gear and a rear planet carrier. This aluminum housing here extends up underneath here also. So the carrier is this big long piece. We have the planet gears themselves in the middle here. And we have a B3 brake that's going to apply and stop this carrier from rotating in certain gears and in reverse. We have a K3 clutch back here that is connected to the rear sun gear and the center sun gear of our Simpson gear set. We have a B2 brake that's going to grab this housing and keep it from rotating. And both of the K3 clutch and the B2 brake are also connected inside to an F2 sprag. So there's two sprags, F1 sprag, F2 sprag, that holds while accelerating. And then our output shaft here is connected to the center planet carrier. And then on the output shaft, we've got our parking gear, our parking pawl. There's a lug that's going to come in and grab this, keep it from rotating, which keeps the drive shaft from rotating and stops the vehicle from moving. We have our output flange that connects to the drive shaft to propel the vehicle. So what I'd like to do is take you through the 5 forward gear ranges and reverse and show you which clutches are applied, which ones are released. We'll do the gear ratios, we'll count the number of input turns versus the output turns, and see if we can get all our gears for this demonstration. So for first gear, we apply the B1 brake, which is down in here. In this demonstration, I'm going to use a screwdriver and just wedge it in place, which will hold that housing from turning, the same housing that the B1 brake would apply and hold. We're going to hold the B2 brake from turning. We have the K3 clutch applied, which connects it to the same B2 brake housing. So I'm going to hold those two still. We're going to turn the input shaft, and we're going to expect to get 3.59 turns of the input to 1 turn of the output. So here we go, here's 1 turn, 2 turns, 3 turns, and a half. So 3.59 turns of the input to 1 turn the output. Now for second gear, we'll release the B1 brake, so I'll take that screwdriver out. Let me get our paint marks lined up again. There we go. And now we'll keep the B2 brake applied, so we'll hold this. Now we have the K1 clutch applied. Well, the K1 clutch is what connects these two housings together. So in this demonstration, I've just got a little sheet metal screw I'm going to run in here that will lock those two together. And that does the same job that the clutch, the K1 clutch would do, that's down underneath this housing, if I were able to actually apply it for this demonstration. We have the K3 clutch applied back here, which, just like in first gear, we're going to lock these two together, and now we should get a gear ratio of 2.19 turns, so 2 1/5 turns input to 1 turn of the output. So here we go. Here's 1 turn, of the input, two turns of the input, and about a fifth, 2.19 turns in, one turn out. That's our second gear ratio. All right, let me line our marks back up now. And we will shift to third gear. For third gear, we keep the B2 brake applied, so we'll hold it from turning. We keep the K1 clutch applied, but now we're gonna apply the K2 clutch, which is down underneath here. And it's gonna connect this housing to this planet carrier, and I'm gonna do that with a different sheet metal screw. And so I'm gonna run that in right here. So now we've got everything set up for third gear, and I'm going to hold the B2 brake, the K1 clutch is applied, the K2 clutch is applied, and we should get 1.4 turns of the input to one turn of the output. So here we go. Here's one turn of the input, and not quite a half, 1.4 turns in, one turn out. That gives us third gear, 1.4 to 1. Now to go to fourth gear, we're going to release that B3 brake. We'll keep the K1 clutch applied that hooks these two housings together. We'll keep the K2 clutch applied, which connects this housing to the planet carrier. And now we will apply the K3 clutch, which connects these two housings together. But this time we're not stopping them, we're just connecting them together so that they can rotate together. To do that in this demonstration, I've just got a paper towel I'm going to shove in here, and it's going to wedge in and hold those two pieces together, just like the clutch would if it were in there and applied. So now those two pieces are locked together. For fourth gear, we've got a gear ratio of one turn in equals one turn out. Let's see, I didn't line up our yellow marks, but we'll just use this handle here and our yellow mark here. One turn in equals one turn out. So that's direct drive through this transmission, which is fourth gear. All right, to go to fifth gear, we're going to release the K1 clutch. So we're going to unlock these two. So let me turn it around here, get this screw out of here. So the K1 clutch is released. We'll keep the K2 clutch applied, which it already is. The K3 clutch will be applied, which it already is. And the F1 sprag will hold. But now for fifth gear, we apply the B1 brake. Remember, the B1 brake's up here. So now I'll take my screwdriver, wedge it back in place. And now we should get 0.83 turns in to one turn out. And let's see, let me get the paint marks lined up best I can right there. Okay, here we go. So we've got one full turn out right now, but we have not gone one full turn around. So this is overdrive. We've got 0.83 turns in to one turn out. That is our fifth gear. Now, to go to reverse, we'll keep the B1 brake applied. We'll apply the B3 brake, which is a planet carrier. And if you recall, anytime we hold a planet carrier still, that forces the annulus gear or ring gear and the sun gear to turn opposite directions of each other. We're going to release the B2 brake. So let me get this screw out of here. We're going to keep the K3 clutch applied, which is our paper towel in here. And let's get our marks lined up. There we go. Now our reverse gear ratio is 3.16 to 1. I'm going to hold the B3 brake. I'm going to turn the input shaft the direction the engine normally turns, and notice the output shaft will turn backwards. So here's 1, 2, 3, 0.16, about 3 1/5 turns of the input to one turn of the output for reverse. So this has been a demonstration of the power flow through a NAG1 automatic transmission that's used in Chrysler vehicles with the Hemi.